Assalamu alaikum everyone. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make these blessed days of the Hijjah a blessing for all of us and to allow us to serve Him to the best of our ability. We are continuing with the lessons of Iman and sacrifice from the life of the dear Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. And today's lesson will be from the ayah in Surah Al-Baqarah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala relays to us the interaction that Ibrahim had with the king, one of the kings at his time, and this is ayah 258. Briefly, inshallah, the story is that this king was a tyrant king, and he had reached high levels in power, so much so that he felt that he was had the power of a god, so he expected people to worship him. And then he heard about Ibrahim, who was preaching that there's another god that should be worshipped alone and no other god with him. So he invited Ibrahim to debate him, and so Allah tells us in the ayah, "Alam tara ila alladhi hajja Ibrahima fi rabbih?" Haven't you heard or haven't you seen to the one who has argued or debated Ibrahim about his Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And the reason for this argument is that this man, and atahu Allahu al-mulk, he had given this power, this authority, this kingdom, and he felt the power of it, and so he thought he was Lord. And so Ibrahim, he asks Ibrahim, "Tell me about your Lord." And Ibrahim says, "My Lord is the one who gives life and death." And the king says, "Well, I can do that." And he demonstrated by bringing two people, and he sentenced one of them to death, who was executed, and he pardoned the other one. And he said, "You see, I gave life to one and took life from the other." And so Ibrahim, instead of engaging him in that argument, he said, "Well, my Lord brings the sun from the east. Can you bring it from the west?" And the ayah says, "فَبُهِتَ الَّذِي كَفَرَ." He was confounded, he was befuddled, the king, he didn't know how to answer that. The moral of the story really is that a lot of times when we have power, it translates into arrogance. We feel that we can do whatever we want to do. And this is true of tyrants like this king, and it's also true of any little power that we get, even your everyday bully in the schoolyard. They feel they have a little bit of physical power, so they try to exercise that to abuse other people around them, and everywhere in between. We always fall into that trap that if we have physical, emotional, or even moral authority about someone, we tend to abuse it and use it in a way that is not in line with what Allah wants us to do. And what Ibrahim tells us is that if you have faith, then that power will be checked by the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that we will keep it under check and we will keep it in line with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. So whether we are a king, whether we are a student, whether we are a parent, whether we are a boss at work, wherever we have that authority, we need to be aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we exercise it and how we deal with the people around us. So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us and to make it easy for us to follow Him. And please don't forget to look us up on the internet, irusa.org, and to donate, and you can make your qurbani with us like every year. Thank you very much, and assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.